able to actually not to only deal with 10% of it was quite embarrassing, to be honest. So first of all, what are we talking about on ground improvement plans? I know you just touched on something there. Anyway, we believe we're going to be able to increase that the rate in which we can actually comply with our own rules. But the other points I wanted to make with regard, and I hope, let's say for everyone's sake, and I know it's slightly different, something raised against an elected member rather than a paid member of staff, but I would like to hope that our performance, if there's a complaint against a member of staff, is much better than what we're actually achieving against members, because that is awful. I know in that way for quite a large corporate company, if a complaint is brought against an individual, and it's not carried out against the actual agreed framework, it's done that. No one would ever be disciplined, nothing would ever be brought against anyone in the time frames that we're dealing with, because you're completely out of process, so it just gets thrown out. And I'd like to hope that we're performing better internally, and it's not an indication of how we're performing internally on paid members' complaints as well. But with regard to the 90%, what do we believe has been the hold-up? Is it the level of vexatious claims? Is it the complexity of some of them? But then that goes into what percentage are actually upheld anyway. And does that mean that in reality, after carrying out the investigation, it's many more of them vexatious anyway? So is that something that's causing a logjam? Or what happened even now in the public interest? So basically, where we are now, what are we going to do? What do we believe has been the logjam in the back in the past?
Some of your questions will be answered. Actually, the most pertinent is the one you've just raised, so the where, what, and the pounds next. So the where, most of those failures were in respect of keeping to the initial timetables. So the complaint comes in, and standard is phoned and notified within 5 working days. That wasn't the case in many occasions. If you want me to guess the reason why, it's because, as I said here, it's all about the monitoring office of the individual person sitting in this chair. The person who sat in this chair had a huge number of responsibilities and places. And as you say, a number of those complaints were frankly vexatious or weren't going anywhere. And so if I'm to hazard a guess, it's that they weren't prioritised. Exchange with your previous say, this is the report from the investigator as to why this is going ahead. Are you happy for this investigation to continue, or actually do you think this needs to be brought to a close, either by saying wrap up your investigation, come to review, regardless of people aren't complying with requests for interviews, or actually this is just dragging on too long, it's nonsense, just make it go away.
Phil, do you envisage that from us if that's the case?
Yes. Yes. No, that's not a decision I'd be comfortable in making. And that's part of the issue here, which is because I'm paid to do this, then we will always bend over backwards and bend over backwards and bend over backwards to give particularly members a fair back of the work. And actually being able to bring it to a group of members and say, here's the situation, members, what do you think, allows us to be stronger and more maybe.
Chris?
Sure. I think what you're saying, Phil, I'm not going to disagree completely with it. Although, why bring the two other schemes? Why not say, okay, we do have a protocol, it does have timescales in. Do we need to build an assessment panel to our existing protocol? Or do we have to adopt a new protocol from another council in order to do that? It just seems to be, we have a protocol that has timescales in, it hasn't been followed at 90% of the time. So, you know, why throw the baby out of that, or that? Why don't we just simply say, we have a protocol that's basically acceptable. As officers, we're going to adhere to the timescales. We'd like to build in a bit more with members, so we can have a small panel that could also be involved in this. Why go out and say, well, here's something from North Lincolnshire, well, here's something from Manchester? Why do we want to complicate it that way?
I think, I mean, I'm quite new to this, but I've had a look at our protocol and I think some of it's quite weak. So I think if we're in a position where we're looking at it, we might as well look at it and strengthen it. Make sure that if we're bringing in a panel, if we're going to make sure that we stick to timescales, we might as well look at it, strengthen it, make sure it's doing what it should do. And as one of these recommendations says, bring it back in 12 months. And if it's not working in 12 months, we'll then change it again. But I think now that we're here in this position, you might as well, if it's echoed 90% of the time, something drastically wrong. So we need to, I think, just look at it and strengthen it as best. And we introduce a panel to it as well, so we've got oversight, more oversight of what's happening. I think that that would be nothing but good for everybody involved, really. So, sorry, Phil, I know you wanted to say something.
I was only going to say, taking the maybe out of the bath water, so the bath is a bit busty in this case, and isn't quite up to it. So it was that point, which was actually, if you're looking at the protocol, there's a good chance to look at the protocol, and of course, because this is an extraordinary meeting, there wasn't time to go away and do research and actually draft a new protocol from scratch. So the best thing that we thought to do was put before you those who we have employed in the past to do investigations, and just said to them, well, okay, here's ours, have you got anything that are better? So they both, the firms came back and said, here's one that we use and we like. So I thought it best to put that before you to say, well, here are the other choices. Now, these may be things that you'd like to discuss further at length, and indeed you may want to send us away and go, actually, given everything that we've heard and everything more that you might have to say, go away and write something. I'm in your hands, but thought best to put that before you and to say at page 17 that puts in three particular areas where there's an issue with your protocol, but there's an issue not, one of which is of course your current protocol allows for rights of appeal. In the days of being able to suspend a member, that was my topper. In these days of action and sanctions, and actions are one of the most robust. Is it appropriate to have an extra appeal layer or not? That's what most councils talk about. So that's an example of changes. So a few suggestions there of where others might be a bit better than this. But I'm just as happy to take your comments and the things. the same item back again in a few weeks for you to discuss further and go away and write something from scratch, give you a little time to do it.
Would you like an
Andrew? Yeah. Yeah, I like the idea of us kind of doing that hybrid and getting, you know, the best bits from Saunders, maybe just got monopoly, have they of good ideas. I think Councillor Cox also mentioned around in terms of like the flow chart, in terms of what the time scales are. So you can see on a page at a glance how the process should flow and what some of the key time scales are as well. So that's certainly something that I would like to see you know, in our amended version.
Yeah, I think it would be right to go away and look at a bespoke to our council. Perhaps taking some of the things from the other councils,
yeah,
some of our existing things. Because if I look at this one again from North Lincoln, it is confusing in some of it where it says, will your complaint be investigated? And it says, talks about Appendix 3 and Appendix 4, and trying to look at Appendix 3 and Appendix 4 in relation to it makes it very complex. But it says that in there, and after consultation with an independent person, take the decision of whether a formal investigation is made. But then the next paragraph says, the monitor officer may, however, in its discretion, prefer a complaint to an assessment panel to assess whether it feels that people are appropriate to do so, such as whether the monitor officer has had prior involvement in the complaint. So does that override the decision to investigate with the independent person? And does that assessment panel determine whether it should be investigated? Does that happen alongside it? Does that, taking it from there to the assessment panel, delay the process? If it does, then we don't want to delay the process. And then we look at decisions of whether a complaint can be investigated will only be taken within 28 days when we see it within place. I would say, you know, we should break that down to nearly 14 days within 28 days.